Quebec. It is a French-speaking province in English-speaking Canada. To ensure the preservation of French, there are many language laws that are unique to the province. Bill 101, for example, requires that all students should attend school in French up to cégep unless both of their parents have attended school in English. Bill 86 states that all commercial signs and inscriptions should be written in French, and if any other languages are displayed, they need to be no bigger than half of the size of the French inscription. Many of these laws violate the Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms and were enforced using the notwithstanding clause, which is rarely evoked because it is seen as unethical as it lets the implementation of a law despite the Constitution. Meanwhile, knowledge of French and bilingualism have increased. However, knowledge of French has always seemed to be a lot more dominant throughout the years. Then, why is it still considered fragile to the point of still implementing laws that violate our own constitution? Some say that being the only French province in Canada, Quebec is in a sea of English, and measures must be taken to preserve the heritage of the language. However, in today's worldwide of connectivity, the whole world is in a sea of English. Moreover, English is the closest thing we have to a universal language. It is also the language of business, and learning it is usually encouraged all over the world. Others claim that these language laws have a hidden agenda. They seek to provide for referendums for Quebec's independence. Although there is a correlation, this statement cannot be proved. Moreover, these referendums have not been successful, even if the majority of the population speaks French. Perhaps they no longer feel the need to separate, as language laws make it easy for them to live and work in Quebec in French. Another argument is that Quebec accepts 45,000 immigrants per year, especially in areas like Montreal. Without language laws, these immigrants will quickly overpower French speakers. Let's see how relevant this statement is today. According to census data from Statistics Canada, in 2011, only 14% of the Quebec's population is constituted of allophones, and 78% of the population are native French speakers. Moreover, only 1% of the total population does not speak any of the official languages, and if we count those who speak both languages, the number of French speakers goes up to 95%. In multicultural Montreal, as well as 1/3 of the population consists of allophones, and French, as a mother tongue, is down to 50%, but still a dominant majority. But similarly to the province's stats, allophones who do not speak French or English are only 3% of the total population, and the amount of people who actually speak French goes up to 87%. The stats reveal two facts. Number one, whenever we look at native or learned languages on both levels of the map, French is dominant and not even close to being fragile or endangered. Number two, Montreal stands in Quebec as uniquely as Quebec stands in Canada. Maybe laws need to be custom tailored also for the city to preserve its multicultural character. What are the consequences of these laws? For the individual, while they encourage allophones and anglophones to learn French, they deny the fundamental rights of allophones and francophones to learn English, and thus reducing their chance for opportunity in well-paid successful industries. For society, while trying to unite it through one French culture, it creates social division due to pressure, discrimination, and violation of fundamental rights of some to satisfy the feeling of comfort and patriotism of others. As for the economy, the social language conflict, the constant threat of separatism, the laws that increase cost and complicate business influence big companies and enterprises to get established elsewhere. Sun Life, RBC, and even Bank of Montreal have moved their main headquarters to Toronto. All of this is to say that language laws are like sugar in a cup of fresh morning coffee. If you have none, it tastes bitter, but if you put too much, it isn't drinkable. You need to find the right formula for the right taste to achieve harmony.